Hey everybody, we're back and we are going to be talking about systems of government today. Systems of government are very different than what we have been studying, which are forms of government. We're going to be going over all of the different kinds of systems of government you need to know for your test. Systems of government are actually very, very interesting because they can be applied to many, many different governments. Oh wait, that's right. You don't care, you just want to know what you need to know for your test. So let's get right to it. And the first thing that we need to get into our heads and burn into our brains is that forms do not equal systems. Forms of government ask the question, who has power? And systems of government ask something entirely different. When we go and look at a country's form of government, we might find a monarch. We might find a dictator. We could find a president. We could find an oligarchy. We could even find a chairman. It doesn't really matter. That's the form. That's who rules. Under a system of government, we're looking at the way power flows in this government and how the central and regional governments interact with one another. Now, the analogy I like to use with my students between forms and systems of government is a form of government is like a type of car. We could have an oligarchy in a sedan, a democracy in an SUV, a dictator in a truck, a monarchy in a convertible. So for example, Spain, the UK, Thailand, New Zealand, they're all driving a convertible because they all have a monarch. But their systems of government, or what's under the hood of their convertible, might be very different. The system of government is actually focusing on the engine inside. How is power moving around in that country? And there's only a few types of engines that there could possibly be, but we need to learn those for our systems of government. So let's try and define a system of government in the notes. A system of government is the relationship between central and regional governments. You can also write in quotations how power flows in a government. And let's just remind ourselves of what central government is. In the United States, that would be like Washington, D.C. The regional or state governments would be all of the other local states. There would be 50 smaller governments sort of running the show in their own state. Again, this would be symbolized by the President of the United States and Congress and the central government and regional governments, people like Governor Rick Scott and the Florida Senate. And in all systems of government, power from the central to the regional government could go in many ways. It could be shared by both of them. It could move in one direction towards central government or in the other direction towards regional government. Now, the first system of government we are going to go over is a federal system, and that's because that's what we have in the United States. And a federal system can be defined as a system of government where the central and regional governments share power. If you've ever wondered about things like driver's licenses, why driver's license ages change from state to state. Here in the state of Florida, you can be 16 years old and have your complete license. Some states it's 17, other states it's 14. The reason for that is because the states or the regional governments have the power, they share that power with the central government to make those changes. Now, South Dakota, you can drive when you're 14 because it kind of looks like this. And maybe in New Jersey, where you have to be 17, it's probably because the roads tend to look like that. Now, for drinking ages, like consuming alcohol, that does not change in any state. You have to be 21 years old across the board. And so when we think about who has power to change that law, that would be the federal or central government. Now, you may be surprised to know that the federal system of government is very uncommon. Only about 25 of 195 countries, or 13%, are going to actually share power with the central and regional governments. What is the most common system is the unitary system, and we can define that as a system of government where the central government has all the power. This is the most common system in the world. It's not where the central and regional government share power. No, that's not how it works. The central government has all of the power, and they are going to tell the regional governments how they should run the show. The central government might tell them to roll over, and they'll do it, or jump, and they have to do it. Or finger paint. Here is a map with the countries of a federal system, and here's a map of a country with the unitary system. You can see this is the most popular system in all of the world. It's just easier. It's easier when one person tells us what to do. There's more control. All right, so let's get to the last system of government we need to know, and that's a confederal system. And this can be defined as a system of government where the regional government has all of the power. You heard it right, the regional government has all the power. This means the state governments like Florida and Georgia and Texas could tell Washington, D.C. what to do, or they wouldn't have to listen to Washington, D.C., which is crazy. So the central government is not going to be telling the regional government what to do. The regional government is going to be telling the central government how they want to do things, what kind of money they want to have in their country, what kind of laws and rules they want to have in their country. So if the central government said, hey, you know, you need to roll over, you need to jump, you need to finger paint, the regional governments are just going to say, nah, I don't think so, not this time, because we call the shots. We have the power, you do not. So in a confederal system, every state or regional government will have its own agenda, its own personality. It will be very individualistic, almost like they were separate countries, sort of working together loosely in a group. Now, they could have their own money. Each state or regional government could have its own laws. The central government is really too weak to enforce them to all follow the same rules because each state is going to do whatever it pleases. Now, when these state or regional governments need help, they can join forces together and work to accomplish something militarily, to defend themselves, or for the economy. So in that way, they're still a country using a confederal system, but in a lot of ways, they're kind of acting on their own for most of the time. Now check out this map. Confederal systems really can't be found anywhere in the world right now as far as single countries go. Believe it or not, the United States of America started out as a confederal system. The original 13 colonies acted as their own countries in many ways. We wrote a document called the Articles of Confederation. States have all the powers. The states told the central government, like what they wanted to do and what they didn't want to do. Every state had sort of their own money and they kind of had their own interests. And it was a total train wreck. I mean, epic failure, which is why we wrote our new constitution with a federal system. Okay, so let's review. How are forms and systems of government different? Remember, forms ask the question, who has power? Systems really care about the relationship of the central and regional government and how power flows. Okay, up next we have a scenario question. You're gonna see a lot of these on your test, your state test, and your test with your teachers. They're gonna describe a country. It could be a real country, or in this case, country X. And it goes like this. Country X has a dictator who runs a central government. The dictator tells the regional governments what to do and they must follow. The regional governments have no power to make laws on their own without the central government. What system of government is this describing? And the correct answer is unitary. Remember, this is the most popular system of government in the world. It's just the central government can kind of tell everybody else what to do and they must follow. They have no other power in the regional or state government. Okay, and the last review question, see if you can get this one right. Country Y has a ruling oligarchy. The central government allows the regional governments to create their own laws and run local programs like police forces. Country Y has what kind of system of government? And the answer is federal system. This is the system of government where we share power. Okay guys, that's it for now. Thanks so much for sticking to the end of my video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. We'll make more videos soon.